Welcome to Medstar Health Mondays on Bascom TV. Today we're going to talk a little bit about the Alter G, which is our anti-gravity treadmill. We have an anti-gravity treadmill at the majority of our outpatient physical therapy sites. We use it for a variety of things, but it is especially good for increasing a patient's ability to get back to running, especially a sport such as soccer. The Alter G was actually designed by NASA. It was actually designed for astronauts to reacclimate them when they came back from outer space. When they were in space and an anti-gravity field, what they were finding was that their astronauts would come back with things like muscle weakness, and they were very injury prone. So they created this machine, and the way it works is that air fills around you, and you're gonna be sealed in there with an airtight seal. And as that air fills around you, we have the ability to lower your body weight all the way from 100% down to 20%. And we can lower your body weight by 1% increments, which is great. We can take an athlete, have them run at 75% of their body weight. There's less stress on their lower body, which makes it easier to run. So for example, a patient that has a stress fracture or an ACL reconstruction can get back to running and sport performance much earlier in the rehab process. When you come in for a session in the Alter G, the first thing you're gonna do is put on these handy dandy shorts. The shorts will go on like so, right over top of your pants. And once we have the shorts on, these shorts will be utilized to zip you into the machine to create that airtight seal. As I mentioned, these are spandex, so they're gonna be a little bit tight. Please don't laugh at me as I put these on. So we're gonna have the patient put the shorts on. We have sizes from extra small all the way up to triple XL. So you want them to be nice and snug, like that. And now I'm ready to get in the Alter G. So now we have our shorts on, we're gonna go ahead and get into the Alter G. As you can see, the Alter G is raised up. We're gonna lower the deck down like this for our patients. A clinic assistant or one of our therapists will be here to assist the patient getting in and out. We're gonna step up, step into the machine, and we're gonna stand right on the treadmill belt. This is gonna pull up around you. So similar to being in a pool, if you were in deeper water, you're gonna have more support so we can make it higher. If you're in more shallow water, you would have less support. So we'll set it here. We're going to lock it in place. And then we're going to zip into the machine. So what's really great about this is that you're not really a fall risk once you're zipped into the machine like this. I'm doing it backwards. I apologize. Backwards again. All right, third time's the charm. Now, ordinarily, I wouldn't be zipping myself in. I would have somebody assist me in doing that. So once we're completely zipped in, we're ready to go. We're gonna start the machine. The machine is gonna start by calibrating your specific body weight. And in doing so, it's unique to every patient that gets in here. So as you'll see, the bag's gonna fill with air around me. As it calibrates, it's gonna lift you up on your toes a little bit. Back down. It's running through the final part of its calibration right now. Now it's fully calibrated. Once it's fully calibrated, as I said, we can control your weight through here. We got a close-up shot of here. We can see that it says right now it's 100% of my body weight. So this is just like walking on a regular treadmill or running outside. The great thing about this is we can lower the weight control by 1% increments. We can take it all the way down to about 20%. For now's purposes, we'll set it at about 65%. The air around it is basically lifting me up. And in doing so, when I walk or run, I'm not going to get full pressure down on the ground. And then we can start our treadmill belt here with normal walking. The treadmill has a speed speedometer. It also has an incline where we can take the incline up or down. And in a normal walking scenario, we usually have people walk for a couple of minutes and then take the speed up. If someone's having pain, we'll usually lower their body weight down and make it even less. Let's take it out for a test run. Right now I'm running at about 7 miles an hour at about 65% of my body weight. The other nice thing about the Alter G is you can see it's clear around the ends. So the therapist can watch you, they can video you and look at what your gait mechanics look like. I'm going to start running because after 30 seconds I'm tired. The other nice thing about the Alter G is that you don't have to walk in it. You can also do exercises, which take away your body weight. Again, I'm at 65% of my body weight. I can do exercises like squats, or toe raises, or kicking your leg out, or marches. It's just a really great way to recover faster with less impact, especially for those athletes that can't put full body weight on their legs. So that's your introduction to the Alter G. Hope you enjoyed it. Hopefully you don't have to use it, but if you do, come to see us at one of our Medstar Health centers.
Hi, my name is Ryan Zimmerman, Clinic Director and Physical Therapist here at Medstar Health Physical Therapy in Rosedale. We have several programs here that help athletes get back to the field sooner. Those programs include an Alter G that allows us to decrease a patient's weight so that they can get back onto their feet quicker, concussion-trained therapists, dry needling trained therapists, as well as two therapists specialized in return to sports.
Hi guys, my name is Marie Lucas and I'm a strength and conditioning coach for MedStar Sports Performance. Today I'm going to show you a couple core exercises you can do utilizing a physio ball.
Here we got a front plank. We want to make sure our arms are at 90 degrees and we're pushing against the ball, making sure we're not letting everything sink down. Keep it up. For stir the pot, we're going to be up here in a plank position and we're going to do tiny circles in both directions. Physio ball, dead bug, our lower back is pressed into the floor, arms and legs are up straight, opposite arm, opposite leg comes down, foot is dorsiflexed, and we only go down as low as we can without compromising that lower back position. The adductor side plank, we're just going to be up in a side plank, make sure we're squeezing our abs, and then I'm squeezing the ball as hard as I possibly can. For a knee tuck, feet start on top of the ball, I'm going to crunch in, bring my knees to my chest, keeping my abs tight the whole time.
This time we're going to do some balance for time. So you're going to do single leg balance. Pick whatever one you want to do. I would pick your dominant one. You're probably going to be better on it. So leg needs to be straight. Other leg can't be touching. This leg can't tap down. Okay, so get your balance. It's better to keep your arms and body close together. And then when you're ready, you're going to close your eyes. And then you're going to balance and see how long you can do that for. Alright guys, so I got 3 minutes and 40 seconds, which I think is pretty good. So let's see what you guys got. Try it out and make sure you tag us at